living on.
Well, this, the last time we were here, the lake was kind of full of water. This time, I'll try and zoom in because I don't see any water at all. I think there's patches of water. But obviously it's intended to be a little picnic area. And I think basically I'm going to walk over and get some shade while Donna stays in the car with the AC. Are you saying hello, darling? All right. Now, I read about this place on a blog when people were talking about coming down for camping, and we thought it would be a good idea because it also talked about fishing, and apparently there are tilapia in this lake. Oh, goodness knows how any of them survive. Again, I'll zoom down here because over there I think there's some water. The reason we're not going down that track closer to the lake and onto that next platform was the last time we drove down there, we did just that. And when we came back, we got stuck in the sand over there. And when we arrived, it was like this. There was nobody here, and I must admit I was beginning to panic. And then, as I was shoveling sand out of the way by hand, I realized that I had, from up here, an audience, and a very kind gentleman came down to help me let some air out the tires, because that's what you're supposed to do when you're driving on soft sand. And then a further bunch of guys came down with a big Land Cruiser, and they proceeded to haul me out, or at least guide me out. And I got out, and I drove up to the top, and I got out to thank them, only to see that they too were stuck. So all around this place there are these little shelters, and as you can see there's quite a bit of vegetation, something that nobody really expects when you talk about living in this part of the world. And I'm sure that at some stages, and there is rain here but not very often and not very much, that this fills up. It's so incredibly hot just now. I mean, this is September and one would normally expect the temperature to be getting cooler, and it's not. It is, according to the car, 42 degrees Celsius. Not sure what that translates into Fahrenheit, but again, you can see over there that green mound, and it's really surprising. It's what can be grown when there's irrigation. And later on, when we're intending, well, after lunch, we intend to go, or hopefully find, the botanical gardens. And so we'll catch up with you then. This is Scotsman in the desert.
And this is Scotsman in the desert saying thanks for watching. If you would like, comment, share, and subscribe, please. We'd love it.